The relaxing waterfall seems to be heightening the Pokemon's concentration. The blue corner suddenly calls their Pokemon back. Gligar is sent out. And now, the battle begins. The red corner makes the first attack. It hits. The situation is a bit of a stalemate. It's a mental tug of war as they anticipate each other's move. Hit! The battle is getting intense! A heated battle is unfolding in the Colosseum. Its attack missed! Nicely done! The blue corner faces a great deal of pressure. The air in the Colosseum is tense. Slammed him! It's down and out! Staravia is sent out. The red corner has the lead when comparing the number of remaining Pokemon. But we still can't predict the outcome of the battle. A fierce blow! Such amazing power! Well, both corners still have a chance to win this. What kind of developments can we expect to see next? Rushing blow! It went down! Combusken is sent out. The end of the battle is getting closer by the minute. A fierce blow! It's a direct hit! The battle is getting intense! Firo suffers from its burn. This is getting dangerous! Combusken desperately holds on. Aerial Ace hits. It couldn't take it. It's down! Game, set, and match. It's a total victory for the red corner.
Hey, it's Yowly Break, and it's time for an open 2-hour mic session with Pokemon God 777.
And me, G-Force Fly, leading off.
Yeah, that was probably the most awkward I could have made the open mic 2 hours starting.
Oh, the what faces.
Oh yeah, they're starting off now.
So, without further ado, it's time to play Who's That Pokemon? One hint is from Wrong Dan's game. It draws out and controls the hidden power of flowers. The flower holds its most likely part of its body.
Hint number two, appears unaware and totally vacant. However, if its chronic headache worsens, it starts exhibiting peculiar powers.
And when it finds a flower it likes, it dwells on that flower its whole life long. It floats in the wind's embrace with an untroubled heart.
So, Flabébé?
Sounds like it. And it does sound like Psyduck is Wrong Dan's game.
When is Psyduck not Wong Dan's game?
Well, we got some matches going. We have codename Scene.
I personally want codename Kowa because I'm a contrarian that apparently likes metronome matches.
Yeah, me too. So Scene is Parley, Charizard, and Rhyperior versus Permasmug, Unknown, and Streamer. QOWA is a standard metronome match. And Wusu is Registeel.
I'm trying to weigh towards metronome because it's not going to win. Oh, well, wait, maybe it is. Maybe it is.
50 seconds left in this hourly break. Our metronome match, the hour, is currently leading with 8 tokens. Make that 10 tokens.
This is all going to be worth it. No, it isn't.
Scene's got the lead now with 11 tokens. Let's see what happens.
It's like trying to bid, watch an auction bid. It just keeps getting swapped around higher and higher.
Yes, indeed. The action is fierce. We have now a new match with all Yolomons.
Challenger approaching.
That's only got 2 tokens, not 17. And Scene will win the token match bid, and Flat Baby from Gen 6, who we see a lot of, is indeed that Pokemon.
Well, rest in peace, the dream of Metronome.
Yep, and I don't get to say my signature line either.
And I don't get to do my bad, awful, stupid memes either. But hey, we can still continue with Pokemon Crash Gray over here.
Yes, we have 1 token on the line. I don't see Breegriff in the chat, so get an input in for a chance to win a token.
Just the one, though.
And the token will go to Mean Raccoon, Dan's game. So now we have a normal match, but switching off, as is the case with all token matches, the blue team will have Perugly, Charizard, and Rhyperior.
And on the red team, we got the Magnezone, A Unknown, and Arceus Electric. Just a single Unknown, though. Hey, was the Stadium 2 Unknown actually Hidden Power Dragon?
I guess.
Thinking emoji.
So we have just over 2 minutes left here in this betting period. What do you think may happen, Pokemon God?
My expert bout, like Swift Assist, I actually don't know what's gonna happen here. It looks like it could be anyone's game.
Yeah, that assist could be... Especially if Perugly draws assist Earth Power, Magnezone can get one-shotted.
Yeah, and it doesn't have Magnet Rise to take advantage of. Also, what's with that Charizard knowing, like, Flare Blitz and Dragon? What's in Smash, it can't have both at the same time, it's one or the other. Come on, at least give it Flamethrower over one of the two.
Yeah, I know. But there isn't a lot of betting yet, but there's still plenty of time left in this betting period.
I still can't wait for that assist hidden power, and we don't know what the hidden power is gonna be.
You're right. That would be very interesting.
Yeah, but in, like, seriousness, it could pull, like, assist Flare Blitz, Earth Power, or, Flare Blitz, Earth Power, or Rock Smash. There we go.
Or fly, even though it would do nothing. It'd be funny to see Perugly in the sky.
Yeah, have you ever seen a flying cat? Well, I mean, they say that toast never falls. The toast always falls butter side first, and cats always land on their feet. So how do you go about strapping buttered toast to a cat and making it form?
Okay, we have less than 30 seconds left here in this betting period for our token match of the hour.
Also, PR station's gone. We put him back in the box with the rest of the Pokemon.
Looks like we're going to be hearing some Sandstorm, but there's no Pokemon in this match that have the move, or Sandstream for that matter.
Yeah. But nice pandering to my meme tastes.
Okay, so the betting period is over, and the blue team has a 154% potential payout should they win this match. So it will be Perugly, and it will be Magnezone to lead off this token match in the Waterfall Coliseum.
Yeah, so we are going to be leading off with the faster Perugly here. It's going to be putting off an assist, but what's it going to use? Oh, that's my one hit.
Yes, and it's going to do probably like 3 damage to this Magnezone on the next turn.
I think you're being generous.
It actually did a little bit more than I thought. Anyways, Magnezone now turns to Charge Beam. Critical hit!
Yeah,
and he's at 1/3 health.
You're going to get the special attack boost?
Yes.
Yeah, this is not looking good for the blue corner. Really?
Yep. Really? Really.
Nice RNG you got in that game.
Yeah, 1 in 8 chance to pick the same move twice. Actually make that 1 in 64.
Yeah, 1 in 64, so that's not awful odds.
And Perugly is taken down.
And another special attack boost, ow.
And now Magnezone is in pretty darn good shape. The red team will send out its Charizard into battle. Let's see if it could do anything to this Magnezone.
Well, it could pull off a Flare Blitz as it's probably faster, but I don't think they're doing so well on the Smooth Switch. Yeah, there's a Dragon Ball.
Yeah. Nice. It didn't do much damage at all, so Magnezone now is going to use a Charge Beam.
Probably
going
for the one
hit. Charizard is one-shotted.
Yep, thought so.
Now the blue team's hopes are going to have to be from the maybe superior Rhyperior. We'll find out.
I mean, is Rhyperior faster than a Magnezone?
Not no. This time. Super effective damage and this game is over. It's an easy victory for the red team.
Yeah, rest in peace, blue team. You didn't stand a chance there with those four moves pulled from assist.
So now our next set of commentators will be coming in just a moment.
Yeah, it's a revolving